Welcome to this video on the financial statements, their formulas, and their relationships. The primary goal of financial accounting is to present the financial statements, which is the way that we communicate the financial results for the period. We're going to be covering some key accounting terms along with the financial statement formulas and relationships. In order to get started, we're going to start down here with the third financial statement called the balance sheet. I'll explain why in a moment. The balance sheet has three items, sections, or components. They are the assets, liabilities, and equity. Assets are defined then as the resources owned by the business, whereas liabilities then are the claims or obligations against those assets. These are debts, liabilities, obligations. And finally, equity is the owner's claims to the assets. In other words, the assets minus the liabilities is what is the owner's share of those assets. The balance sheet formula is assets always have to equal the total liabilities plus the equity added together. In this example, we can see that the total assets of the business are $16,450, and this equals the total liabilities of $400 plus the total equity of $16,050. So the total liabilities and equity is also $16,450. And that is where the balance sheet got its name, is from the formula. It always has to balance. Another name for the balance sheet is the statement of financial position. Now we will come up and start with the first financial statement, which is called the income statement. The income statement has revenues, which are inflows of assets by being in business, which is why I had to start with the balance sheet to give you the definition of an asset, which, remember, are the resources owned by the business. So this is inflows of assets by doing what it is the business is, their business. Next, we have expenses. Expenses then are outflows of assets, again by running your business. And here is the income statement formula, which is the answer to what is the final solution on the income statement, is something called net income or profit. The income statement formula then is revenues minus expenses equals net income. In this case, revenues of $7,500 minus expenses of $4,450 equals our net income or profit of $3,050. Next, let's move to the statement of equity. The longer name is called the statement of changes in equity. I like the longer name because it helps to describe the purpose of the statement of equity, which is to describe how equity changed during a period of time. What was our beginning equity? What made it go up and down? And what's our ending equity? The formula then for the statement of equity is we take the beginning equity balance. In this example, it's zero because we just started this business, this accounting period. I'll describe that in a minute. Now, what made the owner's equity or the owner's share of the assets? Remember that definition from the balance sheet. What made it go up? Items that make owner's equity go up are any owner investments or owner contributions into the business. In this case, this owner had invested $15,000 to start the business. The other thing that makes owner's equity go up is net income. And this is getting us into what is the relationships between the two, excuse me, all of the financial statements. In this case, the income statement is what we call the first financial statement because we need to calculate net income on the income statement, and the relationship between the income statement and the statement of equity is that the net income has to be calculated, and then net income makes equity go up. Obviously, if you had what is called a net loss, in other words, if your expenses were greater than your revenues, this income statement final amount would be negative, and that would move down to the statement of equity as a negative number, which would then actually decrease equity in the case of a net loss. The other thing that makes equity go down is owner's withdrawals. Owner's withdrawals are any time assets are taken out by the owner, it would reduce owner's equity. So the statement of equity formula is the beginning balance plus any owner investments or contributions plus net income if we had a positive profit, or minus net loss if we had a negative amount there, and minus owner's withdrawals equals ending equity. Whoops, sorry, missed getting that on the statement there. That's critical. Okay, all right, now let's show you what the relationship is between the statement of equity and the balance sheet. Again, the net income amount, I showed it in purple here, is the relationship between the income statement and the statement of equity. Now, the relationship between the statement of equity, our second financial statement, and the third financial statement, the balance sheet, is this ending equity balance. Remember, the balance sheet formula was assets always have to equal liabilities plus ending equity. And I went ahead and put this amount on the statement of equity as the ending equity, a balance is what moves down to the balance sheet. And then again, the balance sheet must balance. There is actually a fourth financial statement called the statement of cash flows, and the statement of cash flows will be described at a later time. The last thing I wanted to describe was the headers on the financial statement, with this third line being very important. All financial statements have the name of the company and the name of the financial statement. However, there is a third piece of information that is critical, and it relates to this sentence over here when I say that the income statement is what is called a period statement. The income statement covers a period of time. In other words, this $3,050 was the excess of revenues over expenses, or the net income amount, for what period of time? If it was for a whole year, maybe that $3,050 isn't a very good number. But we have to be told in this third line of the header here, what is the accounting period? In other words, what does this financial statement represent? And because of the word month there, this would say that the net income of $3,050 was earned, or was the amount of profit in just one month. Happened to be for the month of December in the year 2020. The statement of equity then is also a period statement. What was the beginning equity at the beginning of this accounting period? And some companies use the beginning of the month period. In this case, they could have used December 1st of 2020. And some companies use the ending date of the month before. And so I chose to just show it as this example of November 30th of the year 2020. But what was the beginning equity? How did it change? And what was the ending equity, again, over just one period of time, which in our case was a month? The fourth statement of cash flows, just for your information, is also a period statement. It's the balance sheet here that is our odd duck. The balance sheet is not covering a period of time. In this example, we didn't have $2,900 of a cash asset every day for the month. Notice the header here is just shown as December 31st of 2020, and that just means that that is the balances at that point in time or as of a specific date. So this was a brief overview of your financial statements, their formulas, and their relationships to one another. And we will build off of this in the rest of our accounting knowledge and in the later videos.